Hi, welcome to my channel, the Machine Learning Engineer. In today's video, I will explain you how to combine different chains with different purposes, with different components as well, and how to run them either sequentially or in parallel. As usual, I have prepared some notebooks with, in this case, two examples. One, how to run the two chains sequentially, and the other one, how to combine this as well with other chains running in parallel. And after the chains get an output, combine the output of these two chains running in parallel in another chain that run sequentially after these two are running in parallel. Okay, to give you also some background, we have some videos in the channel which are the background for these two notebooks. One is the one where I explain how to create a probably I can show you here in the channel. So we had this video, LangChain RAG QA tool, Gemini Pro. This is the beginning of the explanation of the background of the one of the use cases I'm going to use, and this is the second one. You can see that all my videos are in two languages, one in Spanish, the other in English. So I'm now explaining you in English, in my bad English, but in English. So these two are the origin of the one I'm going to show you now. Later, in any case, I will put you a link to the videos on the description of the chat of this video. And if you had any way, any problem just to find it, let me know and I will point you out where you can find these videos, just to get the background, because I will not explain again how to create a vector store and how to create a Google search and Google Scholar objects. Just I will go through directly the topic of creating the sequential and the parallel chains. So we start with the sequential. This is based on the QA tool I created on the previous video. Just to give you some small explanation, I create a tool which is ingesting some legal documents, specialized in forensic medicine. I introduce them in a Chroma vector store, and I use this as a context to with a Gemini Pro LLM to answer questions about forensic medicine. The documents are from Spain. The law is Spanish law. It's a project where I'm working on. And again, well, this is the beginning or the background of this project. What is the problem statement? Well, speaking with the stakeholders, they told me that they need to find a solution to specify which specific legislation used to answer a specific question. Why this? Because most of these documents are speaking about the same topic, but at different levels of detail. Governmental law, some other reglements, some other are specific for a region in Spain. And then when you make a question, or you make to the model, and it's using the whole database as a retriever, it's a little bit hard for the model discriminate which one is the better source to use as a context in the answer. And then on what they asked me is just to try to use in the query or to provide in the query the source of the file or the or some specific legislation to answer the query. So meaning that they will choose, for example, this file to answer me specifically the question. If you remember how I create this database, I create a part of the vector embeddings which represent every single page of these documents. I'm showing you here. At the same time, once I create a document in the vector store, I also add some metadata. That is the file or the file name where from which this information is coming from, and also the page. So, and I will use this in combination with an LLM to filter or to narrow the scope or search of the and also the number of documents probably to fine tune the search of the documents that are relevant for the question I'm doing. Okay, let's move to the details, and then I import here the libraries I need. Don't worry, I will upload later on this to the repository as I used to do. You can follow up this on your local environment. I set up the environment with the service account in Google to log in Vertex AI, Gemini key, Gemini API key. And then this is not really needed. This is just to count the number of objects I have, but well, I connect to my persistent database in the folder ChromaDB. I create embeddings for my vector store, and I also create a embedding function. This is just for this statement here, which allow me to count the number of the documents I have in the collection. So you can see here we have 3,807 documents in the database, and again many of them speak about very similar things but with some different levels of detail, and well, some cases just speak about the general rule, some other specify the amounts you need to pay or the percentage of blah blah blah. Well, it's even working with an LLM like Gemini 1.5 is really hard, probably because it's not finding the relevant information. As you can see, we are using a retriever, the retriever by default return for documents, and using cosine similarity, and depending how you formulate the question is going to be very hard for the data vector store to return the relevant documents. That's why we are thinking to narrow or to filter the documents using as well a chain to filter the documents that later we will use to provide a context to the LLM to provide the final answer. And then how we do this? Well, we create an object, an LLM, with we are using the chat Google Generative AI with the Gemini 1.5 Pro. We create here a specific chain with this the type self query retriever. This is doing a query to the retriever itself. This is a chain object. Even when I write here retriever, is a chain. So how we build this chain? We simply create a attribute with the class attribute info. We describe the name. We are using the metadata. You see here a document in my vector store contain metadata, the file name, and the page. So I'm going to pass an input, a parameter in my prompt, which I will tell the LLM which file to use to find the relevant information. So you do it like this. You can specify multiple files depending on your metadata, obviously. If you have more attributes in your metadata, you can specify this with the type, here. You can create as many attribute info as you want. Okay. So then on, I create my chain is a class cell query retriever, and with the method from LLM, you pass the LLM, the vector store, the query just you want to use extract the information. You can personalize this according to your needs, and you pass the parameters. Again, you can pass here, you can build here as much as attributes as you need. It's just a matter just to define it correctly. And then on, once you invoke, you see here I'm just asking to find this specific topic in this document. If you look at the document, this is the this information is in this page, in the part evaluation of neuropathies, peripheral neuropathies, and then I'm looking for this specific information, this paragraph. The document has 272 pages, and then I want to find for that. No? And then you just ask the question, look for the deficit sensorial or dolor. This is this explanation. Look at here, deficit sensorial or dolor. Well, you don't need to specify this exactly the same like it's in the document, but well, it's just an example. And the document I just explained in natural language, get me this from this document. And then when you execute it, you see the retriever, just the LLM is sending a query to the retriever and is finding four documents. If you get to the first one, you exactly find the page where is this information deficit, where is this, let me find you exactly deficit sensorial, here exactly deficit sensorial dollar lesional up to it's a neuron here. Take a look to here and you will see that it's exactly the same. Yeah, there's lesiones de los nervios periféricos, blah blah blah. Oops, one second. So this is the page 37. Well, let me invoke again just to show you how it works. Oops. One second, probably is Yeah, sorry, it was some problems with the memory, but again, you make the you invoke the chain, you pass the question, and also point out to the file where you want to find, and then we get four documents. This is by default, and you can see here number 6 evaluation on neuropathias periféricas. This is exactly the page I'm looking for. And here is exactly deficit sensorial of dolor. Okay, so this is the core of this chain. Now I'm going to create a prompt. In this prompt, I just pass the input and the file name, and I create a second prompt for the second chain. The second chain contains the context and also the input. The input is exactly the same variable that I use for the first chain. What is the context? The context is these files that the first chain return. And then I create with the LangChain expression language, LCEL, I don't know if you are familiar with that, but well, I write you here, take a look on document, online chain documentation. And we create a first change. The first change is the query prompt, this prompt, which is working for the chat prompt template. And you pass the prompt to the retriever. The retriever is only this, what you create here, the SQL query retriever chain. And you create a second prompt with you pass the prompt. The prompt is you are a very helpful assistant, context with the blah blah blah, answer with the context provided. You pass the context, you pass the input, and you return the answer. So you have two chains now, and then on. I'm gonna try as well how it works the second chain. Sorry, the first change, you test this first change in both with what? With file name and input. File name and input. You execute it. Oh, sorry, it's not created. And if you write here, obviously it's going to return the same page than here, 37. And now you invoke the second function. The second function you see here in the context, I pass the DOS. This is just to debug if something is going wrong, and I pass the same input I pass here. And now you can see here, if you print that correctly, this is the output. Blah blah blah. You can verify here las lesiones de los nervios periféricos que producen el déficit, blah blah blah. If you write la gravedad de la pérdida, exactly, it found exactly the same. The exact paragraph I want to retrieve from my vector store. And then now to combine both in a sequential way, we join we connect both the chains in a single one. We name it complete chain. We are going to use a file name item getter, so this is the variable that is used on the first chain. The input is the variable as well used on the first chain. Take a look to how we invoke, and then on these two now will be passed to sorry to the first ch chain. First chain will produce a context, and if you remember, the second chain had this prompt contain content. Context and input. So, how is gonna work this? First of all, it will execute this, and here after executing the first chain, it will produce a context, and with the byte, we pass this through the second chain, with the pass-through assigned the object. And the object is going to return the output in the variable D. We can execute here output. It turned out wrong. And now to invoke the chain, just you do complete chain invoke. You pass the parameters. Parameters are file name and input, the same that is used on the first chain. And simply execute it. And it's going what's going on there. Now you generate here, you see the output is here. You just print the output. And you can see here as well that is exactly the same that you got here. You can also print out the context, and the context are the four documents that the first change identified as the most relevant and pass through the chain to the second component of our sequential chain. Okay? to different, o sea, the output of that chain as input to a second chain and provide a final answer with essentially we are narrowing the number of documents or to finding the most relevant documents according to the source that we want to use to build the answer and also the question that we send to the LLM to answer. And with this context, this context is being retrieved from our vector database, we pass this context, these documents as a source, as an input of the second chain, which is gonna be, is gonna produce the final answer. Okay, this is in few words, this is very simple example. Now we are look at the second one. The second one is based in the second example I mentioned you before. Let me show you again where I have it. Sometimes I don't find it. One second, here. The second example is this video I also did some days ago about how to create a research tool with Google Scholar. So essentially, if you you are not familiar with Google Scholar, it's a tool, it's a search engine, but it's only focusing in scientists and academics de literature, papers, research papers, as you can see here for Science Direct, ResearchGate, Archive, etc. And also bulletins, news, etc. But everything related to the academic community. Here you can find also everything that somebody is publishing all over the world and in different languages. You see here, I think here I have this in Spanish, exactly. Google Académico is in Spanish. I'm looking for aborto, abortion in Spain, and you get here Spain, 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 Spain. Well, everything is in Spanish, no? So you can find it in different languages. This is like a specialized search engine just to find to search for information in academic information, research information. So we use this to find information and related documentation of the very specific topic connected with the project I'm working on in forensic medicine. We decide as well to include as a tool as well the conventional Google search. Google search in Google to find some relevant documents which probably are or not are in Google Scholar. And then I want to combine the output of these two tools, two agents, and in get the output of Google Scholar and also the output of Google, the normal Google search engine, and combine these two output as a context for another chain, which finally will provide the final answer to the user. And then the two search that the ones that we do to Google Scholar and to Google, we run it in parallel. It will produce an output with two components, one component coming from Google Scholar and the second one coming from Google Search. And then we will send these two components to the final chain, and the final chain will take this output, this or sorry, this input, which is the output of the previous two chains, and it will use it to build the final answers that we will return to the user. Okay, let's move on through the sample. We import what we need. Don't worry, I will push all these notebooks to the repository later on, and you can take a look to them. We import the libraries we need. For Google search, you need to create an account. Let me show you how to do it. Let's go to the Google Search API wrapper, and if you find in the documentation, you will see here all what you need. I can copy if you want all what you need to create these two variables. I will put you here in the documentation, which is gonna be easy for you. And let me write this here because you need this to run this experiment. Let me write this tag. Probably tag. Okay, you had how to build it. You will need to activate the custom share API. You need an account in Google. You need to install this as a library. I already had installed, and to create a key, blah blah blah. Follow the instruction, and you will get these two keys. One is just the account number, and the other one is the API key. And with these two, you essentially will be able to use a Google Search client API or Google Search API with a client and find and retrieve relevant information. For Google Scholar, you don't need anything. You just need to import where is this? Google Scholar query run and the Semantic Scholar library, which is unknown, and installing somewhere else. Not here. Let me show you. Is I will put you here as well. A Semantic Scholar. Yeah. No, it's not here. Or yes. Yeah. See this library here. To search in Scholar library, there is two ways. There is one, there is not official Google API. You had a commercial one with some very limited functionalities, free, and you had the Semantic Scholar, which is free of use, and that's why I decided to use it. The rest is libraries, LangChain libraries, and so on. Okay, you import, you create the environment, you connect to Vertex AI, and also import the Gemini API key. We create our LLM with the Gemini 1.5 Flash. We create the Scholar API wrapper, documents as maximum 10,000 characters, and maximum number of documents returned 10. We create a first template where we will send a query, we will provide a context, and we provide an instructions to build the answer. And then in this template, we will use it to the Semantic Scholar query run. And here we create a retrieval chain using this tool, the Semantic Scholar query run. Look at how I'm building the query. So I get when I invoke the chain, I'm going to send a parameter query, and then I pass this with the object runnable pass through to this component, to the Semantic Scholar query run, and it will run a query with these conditions. The ones we specify in the Semantic Scholar API wrapper. That's why we pass it here, these parameters to the query run. And this will provide a context. This context will be passed through as an input to the prompt query. The prompt query we will receive here. The query we will receive here in this variable is the same exactly that we sent here. And then on the prompt, when it's populated, will be sent to the LLM, and the answer of the LLM will be parsed to an string. So we execute the query. Again, this query is done with LCEL, Language Expression Language. And then on, if you want to invoke to test it, just invoke, we pass a query. Retrieval chain invoke, And if you print out, you have what we got from. If you don't specify this, you will get an object, which is the object that return the LLM, which usually is a AI message. That is the what the LLM is returning, containing the input, the answer, and all the information related to the consume of the API. If you pass this through an str output parser, you just simply parsing the output and getting the relevant information back to you. Well, this is one of the chains. The second chain is using essentially Google Search API wrapper, a simple search on the Google search. For this, we are going to use an object web search retriever, which is leveraging the way that is working a vector store. We just use a vector store just to download the relevant web pages from internet. From the search, we transform it into chunks, into long chain documents, and those will be the documents that we will use with the LLM to provide an answer. So first of all, we create the vector store chroma with the embedding function, which is calling essentially to the Google generative AI embeddings, and we are persisting this. This is whatever, because every time is going so every search that you will do, it will be creating some entries on this directory. So we create our web search retriever with the method from LLM. We pass the vector store, our LLM, and our search tool. And then this essentially is a chain. No, sorry, this is a web retriever. It's a retriever. It's a retriever object, and it will get information from internet and will place this information into the Chroma database. Now we activate the login at info level just to also allow the LLM to capture the intermediary steps. We create a prompt and then we just pass a question, and based on this question just provide an answer. And then we create the question, user input, blah blah blah. And then we create the retriever QA with short chain, and from chain type method pass the LLM and the retriever, which is essentially this one that we create here. We pass this to here. Let me run all of them again, because I think some of them are okay. Let me run this. Okay, and now we are going to query again. It's fetching again some documents from internet. These documents are now put it on the vector store, and now we are putting everything in result. If you look at the result answer, you get this. If you look at the result object, it's a dictionary with multiple keys. Oops, it's in upper letters. I think it's not gonna work. You have the question, the answer, and the sources. You can get the sources as well here. Which essentially returns nothing. But okay, usually you should get as well the sources, the HTML pages. I don't know exactly why it's not working here. Probably because I need to configure a little bit more in detail this object, because, well, it had a lot of parameters, but yeah. And also, as we did here in the Google Solar object, you get here a AP wrapper. You have it as well in Google, and you can personalize as well the language, the number of documents, etc., etc. And this is essentially by default. I will take a look how to improve this a little bit better. But okay, in any case, I got some information about SAPO syndrome, which is a very rare condition. And now, what I'm doing here, I'm using the class runable parallel to run these two chains in parallel. Every chain, you have to assign a key. In this case, I use the key solar to run the retrieval chain, which is this one, the one I'm using with Google Scholar. And the second one is Google, which I use this one, QA chain. Okay, so you get the map chain, and then you can invoke the chain just passing the parameters each chain need. The QA chain need the object question and the object, the chain retrieval chain need the parameter query. So you pass essentially parameter query, parameter question, and you can run it. Yeah, sorry, the problem is once you run, you have to rebuild the change components, and this is exactly what I did here. You can see here now, you run the map chain, you get the object Scholar and Google, you get the answer for the Google, and it's exactly the same. You can do as well here, the print the Scholar dictionary, and essentially will be the answer of what we got. No, so now we have two answers. One is coming from Google Scholar, the other one comes from Google. And then on, I want to mix them or to combine them to provide a final answer. And then I create a new template. I just provide some instruction. Then on, I'm going to get the context. The context is going to be the two answers coming from the two different chains. And then I get some instruction here to the LLM to extract the correctly information, extract two dictionaries with Key, Scholar, and Google. This we can automatize this as well. Context of the scholar is the input one, and from the dictionary Google extract the key answer, and this is the input two, and with the input two and input two build the final answer, and the final answer in human language. This is a template, and I create as well a second template with using the LCEL. I pass the prompt to the LLM. So what I'm going to do here is just use the output of the parallel runable parallel chain, use the output, and with the output build pass this output, parse it, and pass it to an LLM, which is the same, this is Google Gemini 1.5 fast, and with these two inputs, I will build a final answer. So to do this, again, I'm creating here a second chain with this prompt lang, and I'm passing the prompt, which is expecting the context and the question. The question is exactly the same that we sent here. And with this context and this question, it will build the final answer according to these instructions. So to do the final chain, I just create an initial chain with this using the item getter from the operator library to get the question. Question is what you send in the dictionary when you are invoking the chain. This you pass it to the question parameter, the query exactly the same. Those two parameters will be used in the map chain. Remember, the map chain contains these two parameters. And then on the output will be the context. And then on the context will be passed through using the runnable pass-through object to the second chain. The second chain is expecting the context. This is the output of the map chain. And also the question. The question is what we send in the initial call. You execute it, and now you can get here. Yeah, here we are assigning the output to the answer D. And now what's going on here is we are running the parallel runnable with these two. We are getting output from these two different places. And then on the, this is producing the context, and the constant we are passing through the second chain. And the second chain will run and will produce a response. The response contains this, and you can see here the D object is the output of the second chain, and this is the output, which is a combination of the outputs that we get from the two different places. You can see here that the response contain the question, the query, which are the two parameters that we send when we invoke the chain, and there is the context. The context is the documents that are generated after the map chain, the chain that is running two tools in parallel, and then you can explore as well the context that we pass to the document. You have here the Scholar answer and the Google answer, and these two again were used to produce the final answer. And this sorry, you can complicate this as much as you want. This is up to you. You can use different sources, you can create your personal custom tools which do whatever you can imagine, querying a database, querying an API that is proprietary, but you just need to create a class which heritage from tool class, or you can decorate a method with the add tool decorator, and with this you just simply had a tool that you can use with whatever functionality you can imagine. You just need to return some context. It can be a text, it can be an object, can be whatever. The only thing that you later on need to parse or provide the instructions necessary to the LLM parse correctly the information and use it. And again, you can create the, you can, here we are running two chains in parallel, but you can have as much as you want, retrieving information from different sources, local APIs, whatever. It's just a matter to create the chains accordingly. We created here differently. One is just looking to using a web search retriever. The other one is using a tool, an agent here, the Semantic Scholar Query Rule. This is completely very flexible. You can do it as you wish. The only thing that you need to create runnable objects or objects with our compliance with a runnable interface, and that they produce an output, and they can be created with this nomenclature as we did here with the LCIL language, the same that we did here. And well, that's all. I think it's quite an extensive topic. I'm going to extend a little bit this. I don't know if I will finally combine the refined search in the QA with the search on Google Scholar, because essentially they are two different use cases, two different requirements. But I just want to give you an idea of how you can combine all the tools, agents, change components that you have in LangChain to finally enrich and refine the search and the information that you pass to the LLMs to build the final answer. Okay, that's all. I hope that you like it and you find it interesting and instructive and useful for your job, for your training. And as I used to say, it is like that. Give me a like, subscribe to the channel if you didn't do it before, and share with your colleagues and friends just to help me to promote my channel in internet or in YouTube, basically. Thank you very much. See you soon.